This video is going to be about solving nonlinear systems of equations. So let's look at a pair of equations and see how we do this. Here I've got two equations. The first one is y equals x squared plus x minus 1. Now, as soon as you see that x squared, you know you've got a quadratic equation, which is nonlinear. It's not a straight line. My second equation is linear. It's y equals negative x plus 2. And let's say I've got to solve this algebraically. Well, a really simple thing to do would be, when you look at the equations, you realize they both begin with y equals. Well, if the right sides, the x squared plus x minus 1 and the negative x plus 2, are both equal to y, then they must be equal to each other. So let's just make them equal to each other. I'm just going to write x squared plus x minus 1. That's the right side of the first equation, equals negative x plus 2. That's the right side of the second equation. And now, if I collect all my terms on the left side and set all that equal to 0, I'm just going to be solving a quadratic equation. So let's see. I've got a negative x over here, so I want to add x to both sides. And I've got a positive 2, so I want to subtract 2 from both sides. So I'm going to end up with x squared plus 2x minus 3 equals 0. And now I'll factor this quadratic expression. So since it begins with x squared, I know that my binomials are both going to begin with x. And the last thing I have here is a negative 3. And the only way I know to make a 3 is a 1 and a 3. And that was negative. So one of these two numbers must be negative. The number in the middle is positive 2. So I'm going to make the positive sign. I'm going to give that to the larger of those two numbers. And I'm going to end up with x minus 1 times x plus 3. And then I'll just set both of these binomials equal to 0. So I've got x minus 1 equals 0, and x plus 3 equals 0. And then solving for x, if I add negative 1 to both sides of this x minus 1 equals 0, I'm going to get x equals 1. And then for the x plus 3 equals 0, I'll subtract 3 from both sides. So I get x equals negative 3. So as far as the x is concerned, x could equal either, probably both, x is going to equal 1 and negative 3. Okay? Let's go back to the original equations and look at them a second. Remember the first equation was a parabola? It's a quadratic equation. Well, that's the reason I'm going to get two answers. Let's just take a quick look at what I'm getting at. The first equation is going to have a graph that goes something like that. And the second equation was a straight line. It's going to have a graph that goes something like this. And so the straight line is going to go through the parabola in two places. What I'm looking for is those two places. So I know what the x's are for the places. All I have to do now is take those x's, like x equals 1. And when x equals 1, let's find out what y is. Well, when x is 1, I've got this y equals x squared plus x minus 1. Well, x squared, 1 squared is 1, plus another 1 is 2, minus 1 is 1. So this should tell me that y equals 1. Let's check it with the second equation. Second equation says y equals negative x plus 2. Well, if x is 1, then negative x is negative 1. Negative 1 plus 2 is 1, so that says y equals 1. So it looks like when x is 1, y is 1 for both of those equations. So I'm going to have an ordered pair, 1, 1. Now the other solution I had was x equals negative 3. So let's see what happens when x is negative 3. When x is negative 3, negative 3 squared is 9, plus negative 3, which is like saying 9 minus 3 is 6, minus 1 is 5. So y should equal 5. Let's check the second equation to make sure that it works for both of them. Negative x, well, if x is negative 3, negative 3 is positive 3, plus 2 is 5. So once again, y equals 5. So I've got two solutions, 1 comma 1 and negative 3 comma 5. Now, remember when I went and just quickly drew this parabola? That kind of hints at a really much faster way to solve this whole problem. All we have to do is take these two equations and put them into a graphing calculator. Now, if we do that, in other words, if we go to the window where you put your equations in, you could have y sub 1 equals x squared plus x minus 1. I've done that in red ink so we can keep the graph separate so we can tell which is which. And then y sub 2 equals negative x plus 2. So those were my original equations. When I graph them, I'm going to have a parabola, that's the red parabola, and the straight line for the linear equation, that's this downward sloping blue line. And the place where those two lines cross, where they intersect, those are going to be the solutions. So then all I have to do is use the intersect function in the calculator, and I'm going to find that my two solutions are negative 3 comma 5 and 1 comma 1. Okay, so two ways to do this. One is you can take your equations, set the x part of them, set those equal to each other, and then solve your quadratic equation. You get all the way down to here, you solve the quadratic equation, then take the two x values and plug them into your original equations to find out what the corresponding y values are going to be. Or if you're allowed to do a graphic solution, you can take your graphing calculator and just plug those two equations into the graphing calculator, find out where the lines intersect. Okay, so that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.